Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do a proof from my real analysis class. This was a proof in one of my quizzes that we had that we were expected to solve like at the last 5 to 10 minutes of class. So it's a pretty short proof, but I think it's good at testing the basic real analysis properties or theorems involving sequences and limits. So this proof says, suppose that x of n and negative 1 to the n times x of n are two convergent sequences. Prove that the limit of x of n is equal to 0. One way of approaching this problem is just taking what we're given and kind of expanding what we know for fact based on the theorems that we learned in class. So one theorem is that for any sequence that converges, that sequence has a unique limit. So if you take the limit of x of n or the limit of negative 1 to the n times x of n to infinity, that will have a unique limit. So the first thing we can say is x of n and negative 1 to the n x of n converge, therefore the limit of x of n and the limit of the other sequence both exist. We don't know what these limits are, so I'm just going to say let the limit of x of n as n goes to infinity equal to x, and we're going to call the other sequence y of n. And this is for any n in the natural numbers. So this is x of n, except the odd numbers are now negative. And another thing that we know just from what we're given is that because a limit exists, we can say that the subsequence of x of n and y of n both must converge to the same limit. So there's a theorem that says if a sequence converges, then every subsequence converges to the same limit. So using that, we can say that all the odds and all the evens subsequences of the sequence will converge. So this is just saying 2k would be any even subsequence, and 2k minus 1 would be any odd subsequence. And those both have to be the same limit, and it has to be the same limit as the sequence, which is x. And we can also say the same thing about y of n. So all the odd and even subsequences also have to have the same limit as y of n. So if we look closer at this subsequence, we have the even subsequence taking the limit of, and also we're taking the limit of all the odd subsequences. So negative 1 to the 2k is going to always be equal to 1. So this is going to always be the limit of x of 2k, because 1 times x of 2k is obviously just x of 2k. And this is going to always be negative 1. So these are always the odd subsequences of this sequence. So this will always be equal to negative x of 2k minus 1. So we already said that x of 2k has to be equal to x, which is the limit that we assigned for the limit of x of n. So we can always say that this is going to be equal to x, and this will be, we can think of this as negative 1 times the limit of x of 2k minus 1. So we can pull out the constant, so that will always be negative x. And there's a theorem that says we're allowed to do that as well. So now we have x is equal to negative x. If we bring the negative x to the same side, we have 2x, or x plus x, which is equal to 2x, which is equal to 0. If we divide by 2 on both sides, we get 0 divided by 2, which is equal to 0. And thus we have proved that the limit of x of n is equal to x, which is equal to 0. And we are done with this proof.